Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this time series problem. So for this problem we're given an AR2 model here and we're asked to find the closed form solution for the autocorrelation function rho of h. So for these types of problems we're asked to find the ACF or autocorrelation function of a causal AR2. So this is a special type of problem because it has basically a nice closed form formula, but what the formula is could be one of three cases. So there's basically two steps for this type of problem. The first thing you want to do is calculate the roots of the AR2 model. So I'm going to put calculate the phi z roots, and this will essentially give you R1, R2, and then the formula is one of three possible cases depending on what roots you get. So in the first case, R1 and R2 can be two distinct real roots. So the first case is if you have two real roots, in which case the autocorrelation function is going to have the following formula. It's going to have C1 times Z1 to the negative h plus C2 Z2 to the negative h. The second possible case is if you have one repeated real root. So this is when R1 is equal to R2, and in that case the formula is going to be Z0 to the negative h times C1 plus C2 times h. And the third possible case is that you have a complex number and you have a complex conjugate pair as R1 and R2. So for case 3 I'm going to put complex conjugate pair, in which case the formula is a little bit more complex. It's going to be rho of h is equal to a times the magnitude of z1 to the negative h times cosine of h theta plus b. So in this case what you're going to get as your real roots is that z is a complex number a plus bi, and then the conjugate of that would be a minus bi. And so the real part of this complex number is the a, then the imaginary part is the b, and z is going to be the magnitude of the complex number. So the formula for z1, or the formula for the magnitude of z1, is going to be the square root of a squared plus b squared. And then to get theta, the formula for that is that theta is equal to tan inverse b over a. So these are all the formulas you need for the third case, and this example that we're going to do is going to be case number 3. So the roots are going to be an imaginary conjugate pair. So let's go ahead and get started with the problem. So like I said, the first thing I'm going to do is find the causal roots. So for this AR2 that we're given, that's going to be 1 minus the phi 1 coefficient, which is minus square root 2 over 2 z plus 1 fourth z squared, and that's going to be set equal to 0 to find the roots. I'm going to rearrange the numbers, so that will be 1 fourth z squared minus square root 2 over 2 z plus 1 is equal to 0. And then before I do the quadratic formula, I'm going to get rid of the denominator, so I'm going to multiply by 4 on both sides, and that's going to give us z squared minus 2 square root 2 z plus 4 is equal to 0. Now I'm going to use the quadratic formula, so that's going to give me 2 square root 2 plus or minus the square root of 2 square root 2 is 8 minus 4 times 4 times 1 divided by 2 times 1, which is just 2. Then when we simplify what's in the square root, that's going to be the square root of 8i divided by 2, which is equal to 2 times the square root of 2i divided by 2. So if we divide by 2 for the real part as well, then our roots are going to be square root of 2 plus or minus square root of 2i. So from this complex number, we have that a is equal to square root of 2 and b, the imaginary part, is equal to square root of 2 as well. So in this case, we're going to have that the magnitude of z is equal to square root of 2 squared plus square root of 2 squared. So that's just the square root of 4, which is going to be equal to 2. And then to find theta, that's going to be tan inverse square root of 2 divided by square root of 2, which is tan inverse of 1, which is going to give us pi over 4. So now we can plug into the formula, which was rho of h is equal to a times the magnitude of z to the negative h times cosine h times theta plus b. And like we said, we have that a is equal to the square root of 2. The magnitude was equal to 2. So 2 to the negative h times cosine theta we have is pi over 4 times h plus the square root of 2. And this is our final answer. And we're done with this problem. Thank you.